is the debt distressed enough in Argentina to, for you to want to buy it?
I guess the short answer is yes. After the primary results, which were quite a bit of a shock, the gap between Alberto Fernandez and Mauricio Macri was close to 18%, and I think the most of the polls had it by 2 or 3%. There was a massive selling pressure by the market. Bonds went from sort of index bonds went from mid-70s dollar price to right now high 30s. So if you are not assuming a broad-based restructuring like Argentina did in 2005, it's certainly worth looking at.
Hans, why wouldn't you assume we won't see a broad-based restructuring?
I think the issue at this point is it's still arguably a liquidity issue. The IMF stepped in. They've had, you know, they've added a lot of debt by trying to support the economy. But it, you know, by most measures, this doesn't look like a solvency problem. It looks like an issue of having to refinance some of the maturities that are coming up in the next couple of years. And a lot of the pressure isn't the international debt, it's the domestic debt. So, you know, if the market can be reasonable, actually, better said, if Argentina can be reasonable and the transition can be smooth, you know, this could work out in a way that Argentina could resume growing.
But Hans, I think you put your finger exactly on the issue. I mean, first of all, we're not exactly sure who it is in Argentina who's calling the shots in the new regime, assuming that, in fact, they get elected. Mr. Fernandez comes in. And secondly, the track record, particularly Mr. Kirchner, was not very attractive. If you're not on the other side of the negotiating table at this point, why would you agree to extend these maturities?
Well, I mean, I think that's a critical point. The Macri government, in a way, when I was down there, it looked like the transition could be actually smooth. There was initially sort of Macri was sort of in denial about the results of the election for the first couple of days. And then there were signs that there was somewhat of a smooth transition. I was there in the first week after the primary. Since then, it looks like Macri's trying to contest the election, or at least was last week, which created a lot of turmoil because, you know, there's not going to be a transition until December. And I think what the market is looking for is a smooth transition, passing of the reins. Now, in terms of the Cristina Fernandez de Kirchner versus Alberto Fernandez risk, most signals are that Alberto Fernandez is going to be, I mean, he is top of the ticket, so he's going to be the one calling the shots. So while I think the market initially was very concerned about Cristina Fernandez de Kirchner coming back in, the signaling that we've gotten from the economic team around Alberto Fernandez and Cristina Fernandez de Kirchner has been pretty market friendly, or at least we're willing to talk about this. We don't want to waste the first 2 years of our administration engaging in long-term restructuring with you guys. So it's ironic in a way that the fear has been the Alberto Fernandez people, but the damage in the last week came from the Macri administration.
100%, Hans. It's like exactly what the market was afraid of, Macri actually did. So if you're looking at Argentina and how to buy, is it like the 100-year bond? What kind of duration? Or is it going to be a provincial debt like Buenos Aires or Neuquén or something like that that is less likely to default regardless of the external threats?
Yeah, I mean, it's good to know. We went through all the restructurings in Argentina 2001 through 2005, and most of the large provinces restructured in better terms sovereign. We've been buyers of the provincial. We've been buyers of the sovereign. I don't think you don't need to overthink this. It's either a good investment or it's not at this point. Where you are in the curve is, I think, sort of less relevant than, you know, which bond is being forcibly sold. It's a tricky market. It's certainly a bit better the last couple of days than it was at the end of August. But either you make an assessment that Argentina is probably going to bounce and not go off a cliff, in which case you look at every opportunity, or you hold off if you think that it's going to get worse.